Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chansom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 28th of May. Major terror attack averted in India's Jammu and Kashmir. Activist families protest against enforced disappearances in Balochistan. And Afghanistan's coronavirus cases tally crosses 12,000 mark. And now for all the details. Indian security forces averted a major car bomb attack by Pakistan-based terror groups in Pulwama district of India's Jammu and Kashmir on Thursday. The plan had chilling similarities with 2009 deadly Pulwama terror attack, which killed 40 Indian paramilitary personnel.
Security forces prevented a massive car bomb attack by Pakistan-based Jaish-e-Mohammed and Hizbul Mujahideen in Pulwama district of India's Jammu and Kashmir, a senior police official said on Thursday. Based on intelligence inputs, a white Hyundai Centro car with a fake registration number was signaled to stop at a checkpoint on Wednesday night, but it tried to accelerate and go through the barricade. The security forces opened fire, but the driver managed to escape, leaving behind the car suspected to be carrying about 40 to 45 kilograms of improvised explosive device. The car, along with the explosives, was later destroyed by the bomb disposal squad. The intensity of the explosion was such that several houses in the area were damaged due to it.
पिछले एक वीक से पुलवामा पुलिस को ये इत्तला मिल रहा था, बार-बार खबर आ रहा था, टेक्निकल एंड से भी ह्यूमन से कि जैश मोहम्मद एच एम मिलकर एक बहुत बड़ा हादसा करने वाला है, उसमें ये लोग कार बम को यूज कर रहा है। तो कल मॉर्निंग में जब हम लोग का खबर पूरा मैच्योर हो गया, तो उसके बाद पुलिस सीआरपीएफ आर्मी ने मिलकर मल्टीपल नाका लगाया। जब नाका पार्टी ने उसको वार्निंग फायर दिया रोकने के लिए, तो वहाँ से भागने में कामयाब हो गया। फिर दूसरा पार्टी जब फायर किया, चूँकि अंधेरा था, उसमें मिलिटेंट भागने में कामयाब हो गया, लेकिन गाड़ी वहाँ छूट गया।
The plan had chilling similarities with last year's Pulwama suicide car bomb attack by Jaish-e-Mohammed, which killed 40 Indian paramilitary personnel. Security officials have said, despite coronavirus pandemic, Pakistan has been helping terrorists infiltrate across the border and mount attacks on Indian soil.
India's Meteorological Department on Thursday said the maximum temperatures in North and Central India are likely to recede from May 28th and predicted rainfall. Parts of India, including capital New Delhi, have been experiencing severe heatwave conditions for the past few days.
In a huge relief to people residing in North India, the India Meteorological Department or IMD said that the temperatures are likely to recede from Thursday. Since past 4 days, some areas of North and Central India have been experiencing severe heat wave conditions with temperatures recorded over 47 degrees Celsius. Some areas even recorded 50 degrees Celsius this week. A senior scientist at the department informed that heat wave conditions in some parts of central India are also likely to reduce from May 29th and rainfall is expected.
और हम जो उम्मीद कर रहे हैं कि आज से जो हीट वेव इंटेंसिटी है काफ़ी कम हो जानी चाहिए, उसका कारण क्या है कि एक वेस्टर्न डिस्टरबेंस है जो अभी अफगानिस्तान और एडजॉइनिंग पाकिस्तान एरिया पे लाई कर रहा है, उसके प्रभाव से अभी वेस्टर्न हिमालय रीजन में भी थोड़ा रेनफॉल एक्टिविटी और सिमिलरली थोड़ा ईस्टर्ली वेव से जो वेव बंगाल से हवाएँ आ रही हैं उसके कारण भी जो पूरा का रीजन नॉर्थ वेस्ट इंडिया सेंट्रल ईस्ट इंडिया में थोड़ा रेनफॉल एक्टिविटी होने की उम्मीद है.
Meanwhile, as India continues its battle against worst desert locust outbreak in decades due to climate change, district administrations in central Panna town used police sirens to scare away the destructive migratory pests. Desert locusts have engulfed around 35,000 hectares in parts of India, threatening vegetable and pulse crops, government officials and farm experts said.
The number of coronavirus cases has been increasing at an alarming rate in India in the last few days. As of Thursday, the number of COVID-19 cases surged to 158,333, while the death toll rose to 4,531. Meanwhile, amid rising cases, migrants continued to return to their hometowns after lockdown restrictions were eased. India's COVID-19 tally reached 158,333 on Thursday, with 6,566 more coronavirus cases reported in the past 24 hours. The number of active coronavirus cases stands at 86,110, and the death toll due to the infection has reached 4,531. Amid rising number of cases, India's recovery rate from the coronavirus disease improved to over 42%. According to Health Ministry, at least 67,692 were cured so far. New cases have emerged in several parts of the country as migrants returned to their hometowns after lockdown restrictions were eased. On Thursday, Eastern West Bengal province resumed its domestic flight services after 2 months of suspension due to the coronavirus-induced lockdown. Flight services couldn't be started on May 25th as the province was involved in relief and restoration work post cyclone Ampan.
Precaution har tarah ka precaution hai aaj gloves pehne hue mere bacche wagera and full clothes pehne hai jagah jagah sanitizers hum log use kar rahe that's the precaution which we are taking we are not touching anything basically.
In India's western Mumbai city, people in large numbers thronged Lokmanya Tilak station on to catch homebound trains on Thursday. Though India is running special trains and buses to allow migrants to leave big cities, the wait to return home for the millions of distressed workers is still long. Moving on, a protest was held recently in Balochistan by political activists and families of missing persons who have been allegedly abducted by Pakistani forces. Activists accuse Pakistani army has been carrying out so-called military operations in the region for years, with an aim to muzzle dissenting voices.
Scores of political activists and families of missing persons in Balochistan recently held a protest outside the Quetta Press Club to secure the safe release of their loved ones who have been abducted by Pakistani forces. A large number of Baloch political activists, intellectuals and innocent civilians have been missing for years. They have allegedly been abducted by Pakistan army and spy agencies and kept in secret cells. Activists accuse Pakistan army has been carrying so-called military operations in the region for years with an aim to eliminate the Baloch people and grab their lands.
बलूचिस्तान को चावनी बना दिया है हर जगह आपके फोर्सेस बैठे हुए हैं कदम कदम पर चेकअप हो रहा है इतने पैसे जो तुमने इस बलूचों को मारने पर खर्च किया अगर ये पैसे बलूचिस्तान में यूनिवर्सिटी मेडिकल कॉलेज या और ये हॉस्पिटल्स बनते तो ये कहां पे पहुंचता
Balochistan is a resource-rich region with huge reserves of minerals and gas, but it remains poor because of the exploitative policies of Islamabad. Activists blame there has been a sharp rise in human rights violations in Balochistan since the launch of the multi-billion China-Pakistan Economic Corridor or CPEC, which has also led to displacement of Baloch people.
With rising number of COVID-19 infected patients daily, Afghanistan's cases tally has crossed 12,000 mark with 227 associated deaths so far. Experts in the country have warned the virus is approaching the peak and any negligence will have dangerous consequences.
Total number of COVID-19 cases in Afghanistan reached 12,456 on Thursday, which includes 1,138 recovered cases and 227 associated deaths. So far, the Health Ministry has tested 33,864 samples, according to a statement by the ministry. The COVID-19 outbreak in Afghanistan began about 3 months ago, and now experts have warned that the virus is approaching the peak and any negligence over it will have dangerous consequences. The crisis is widely expected to have devastating impact on war-ravaged and resource-scarce Afghanistan. And experts have said it could even extract a human toll that will exceed the death toll of decades of fighting in the country.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday spoke to his Sri Lankan counterpart Mahinda Rajapaksa and assured him that India will extend all possible support to the island nation during the challenging times amid coronavirus pandemic. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi, in a telephonic conversation with his Sri Lankan counterpart Mahinda Rajapaksa on Wednesday, assured him that New Delhi will extend all possible support to the island nation during the challenging times amid coronavirus pandemic. According to an official statement, the two leaders also discussed the health and economic impact of the prevailing COVID-19 situation and the measures being taken in the two countries to counter them. Modi also congratulated Rajapaksa for completing 50 years since his first entering the Parliament of Sri Lanka. On the other hand, Rajapaksa called for closer ties. Earlier, newly appointed High Commissioner of India to Sri Lanka, Gopal Bagle, paid his first call on Rajapaksa in capital Colombo and conveyed that India is committed to stand shoulder to shoulder with Sri Lanka in addressing the challenges posed by COVID-19 and in post-COVID economic recovery. Sri Lanka recorded its highest daily total of 150 new COVID-19 cases on Wednesday, raising the total number of coronavirus patients to 1,469. Sri Lankan police on Wednesday arrested the man who set up a snare in which rare black leopard was trapped. Wildlife officials rescued the leopard and snared in the trap on a tea estate in central Nuwara Eliya on Tuesday.
Wildlife officials in Sri Lanka rescued a rare black leopard ensnared in a trap on a tea estate in Nuwara Eliya on Tuesday. The villagers had called for help after hearing the animal growling. The officials tranquilized the leopard with a dart, treated its wounds, and then took it to a nearby conservation office for further treatment before it was released into the nearby jungle. It is believed to be about 8 years old. The leopard belongs to a subspecies native to the island. Black leopards are rare and their color comes from a genetic mutation.
Me vatuhasra janatawa visheshayen danuwath yuthu me wanasathunta mandu gasima danuwan labe hage waradak bawa wanasatta uksalasa araksha aajana bandi pratipadananu apita katayutu karan siddha wenawa.
Meanwhile, Sri Lanka police on Wednesday arrested the man for setting up the snare in which the rare black leopard was trapped. He will be produced in a court.
Superheroes have a special place in the hearts of children and many youngsters. Enthralled by Hollywood superheroes movies, a 20-year-old youth from Northeast India has created a replica of Iron Man out of electronic waste.
A 20-year-old youth from India's northeastern Manipur province has created a replica of iconic character Iron Man from the Marvel series of American superhero films out of electronic waste. Nigombam Prem, who hails from Manipur's Thoibol district, said he created the costume using electronic waste, which he collected from radio and television. Prem has also created several other robotic items with just his observation-driven knowledge. The youth, without having any formal training, now efficiently repairs television, radio and emergency lamps at home that would otherwise require the services of an electrician.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.